It's been a week since I talked to Dr. Now, and I've decided to go ahead and move to Houston.
But I'm terrified. I haven't been out the house
in years.
And I haven't been in a car
in even longer.
So it is very, very frightening to leave everything I know.
But I talked to my friend Michelle, and she's willing to move down to Houston with me. Because Dr. Now didn't think it was a good idea for Taisha to be the one that comes with me, because she's been my biggest enabler. So I've got to do what I need to get my life back on track. My family and everyone is almost done packing everything up. And we have the van that I'm going to be riding down to Houston in, so I'm just about ready to go. We just need to get the mattress in it, and then I need to be carried to it. So EMTs are coming to help me with all that. But I'm a little nervous about it, because it's been a long time since I've been out of this apartment. So I just hope that there are no issues and it all goes well.
Mm-hmm. And we are here to help you get to your van, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. You've been on a stretcher before, correct? Okay. Yeah. Then we'll get rolling, okay? All right.
I'll just sit up on the side of the bed. Oh, geez. Whoa, geez. Now, that ain't never happened. Okay, hit me.
Right there.
All right. Yeah, just stay right there.
Okay.
Get the stretcher in and get you moving.
Okay, cool.
All right, you ready?
Yes, hold my butt, don't fall out.
Count it out for me.
2, 3.
I got you. You ain't going nowhere.
Come on down.
You got it. You can go where
I'm
going.
Well done. All right. Get back here. Here
we go. All right. It's embarrassing to have all of this just to be able to leave my apartment.
All right. Let me get you up here.
There you go.
But I'm doing this to make sure that this isn't my life.
What? You don't trust us?
Don't reach. Swing on the freeway. Okay. Doing good, babe.
Yeah, turn yet. Okay, turn.
All right.
We start moving around this cop.
1.
Let's get her center.
2, 3.
Oh, I'm switching. Passing ahead.
Got it.
Passing
good.
Good. Keep going.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
I know I'm fighting for my life, but it's hard to be leaving my family.
I love y'all. Be good, okay? Promise me.
I'm definitely gonna miss my sister. It's tough to see her go. I wish she could stay here in some way. She can figure it out, but I know it's God's will that she goes down here and does this, and he's gonna take care of her.
I'm confident I can make it as long as I'm careful. I just have to brave the journey and get there. And once I do, I'll have hope waiting for me. It was day 3 of being on the road to Houston for me. I was hoping to be done with all this traveling on the second day, because being loaded and unloaded so many times took so much out of me. And I didn't realize how hard this was gonna be. So I'm just really glad I'm gonna be there soon. But earlier this morning, I called Dr. Now, since I'm so close to Houston, and told him that I'll actually be there soon. But when he heard that I did this without medical transport, he wasn't too happy about that. So he told me that when I get there, he wants me to go to the hospital immediately so that he can make sure nothing's wrong with me. So my family will take all my initial stuff to our new apartment and move in for me while I have all my tests being run. And I'll be done with all this traveling. And hopefully I'll be able to get weight loss surgery soon.
I'm not too happy with Octavia right now. I have wanted her to hit her goal and get to a healthier place to make this trip safer, but it seems she had taken this upon herself to do it her own way. How are you feeling, Octavia?
Feeling okay.
Okay, I want to get you inside as quickly as possible so we can make sure you're okay. Are you able to get up and stand?
No.
Okay, well, let's get you inside. Not only has she risked her health and her life doing this, but if she hasn't hit her goal, this whole trip may be pointless for her because she won't get weight loss surgery until that happens. So right now, I have a lot of concerns about Octavia, and I'm hoping this is not a glimpse of what we can expect with her going forward.
I'm all the way on.
But our priority is to get her in and make sure she doesn't have any life-threatening issues. Okay, we finished running all the tests, and thankfully, all your tests are looking pretty good.
Okay.
You don't have any serious issues right now that we need to address, other than your weight and lack of ability to get up and move, okay?
Okay.
All right, let's check your current weight and see where you're at. £692, almost £700. That's very concerning.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a lot of work to do. We started you on a 1,200 calorie a day diet so we can get your weight down.
Right.
And it's gonna be very important for your weight loss that we get you active. So we're gonna get you to go to rehab for a couple of months and see if we can build up some strength on your lower body that you can get up and walk and take some steps, okay?
Okay.
But after we do that, then you need to show me that you're willing to work hard like you need at home. So it's important for your friend to get those diet instructions so she understands what's going on because she still has some issue with her own weight. And I don't want her enabling you when you go home. So this is gonna be an issue that both you need to work on it at the same time.
Yeah.
But if she's sticking with the diet, be able to lose at least 50 pounds a month.
Okay.
And if you do that, then I will approve you for weight loss surgery. Okay?
Okay.
But at the end of the day, everything is gonna be up to you.
Up to me, yeah.
Okay.
All right. Like you say, you bring the horse to the well, but you can't make him drink, so I got it.
We get the ambulance to take you to rehab, and you're gonna start working with them every day and get up and do your exercises. And hopefully here very soon, we'll get you out of this bed.
Okay.
I'll see you over there.
All right, thank you so much.
And we'll take care of you, okay?
All right, thanks, Dr. Now.
Mm-hmm.